Hello everyone, and welcome to this milestone presentation on what is new in Esprit-ING, step 2.2. Today I'm going to introduce the new global finishing strategy. So, the global finishing cycle generated toolpaths in both steep and shallow areas of the part. The user sets a slope threshold angle. Part areas having a slope above such set value are considered steep. The other areas having a slope below such set value are considered shallow. On the steep areas, the system applies a Z-level type toolpath. On shallow areas, it applies concentric type toolpaths. Both types of toolpaths can be covered in a spiral way. The system tries as much as it can to minimize the number of detaches and reapproaches, linking together, when possible, the Z-level toolpath areas with the concentric one. So let's see this inside Esprit. So here I have ready this part, this part is an electrode of a handle, and I already prepared a freeform feature, but I want to show it because, as you can see, it has set some, in this case, negative stock allowance. So this definition here means that on all the solid, I want to machine with a negative allowance of 0.1 millimeters. This because this is an electrode, and I want to recover what will be the gap in the EDM process. But as you can see here, this space here, I don't want any toolpaths, any allowance on this space here, on this plane. So no allowance on this plane, minus 0.1, all the rest. So let's speak about the global finishing, which is the topic we are interested in now. So global finishing, you can find it and on the end of a list of all the mold finishing cycles. So let's start a default. And so here on the operation name, I set the name global finish. I select the ball mill 4 millimeter diameters. Set at 12,000 RPM and then 1,000 feed rate PM. Now, here you can see the toolpath tab, which is, in my opinion, very simple. So there are a very limited number of parameters. The step over, the default is 10% of the tool diameter. And these are the interesting parameters, particularly the slope angle threshold, which is the threshold which divide the steep from the shallow areas, as I was saying before. So in this case is interesting because as you can see, I can leave everything by default. Here in limits, I just say to stop the toolpath at the limit with the center of the tool at this limit of the model itself. There are special links, particularly studied for this global finish. Collision detection has all the possibility of all the other toolpaths. So this means that in case of collision, you could apply also an auto tilt, for example. But in this case, let's just be simple and I validate. So practically, I have defined very, very few things. So all working with the default values, the system is calculating, and is calculating this toolpath here. So This green here, where the toolpath seems to be above the model itself, is an effect of the negative allowance, while in the plane is on the same level of the plane itself, because here there is no allowance. So let's see the toolpath analysis. So you see that this tool goes spiraling, starting from the top. I can a little bit speed up. And here, particularly, you don't even see that is changing from a concentric path towards a Z-level path. But actually, because of a very smooth connection, is a continuous spiraling. So, and now, of course, the system finds this area here of shallows, and so it cut them. But then it continues, in this case, in Z level. And then, again, on the bottom, in the four corners, are forming four patterns of concentric. Also interesting could be, in this case, to see an effect of the allowance having a comparison. In this case, I set the tolerance 0.01, and I see actually that this red in the solid means that the system cut, as I requested, minus 0.1 millimeter from all the solid itself, except the bottom plane, which instead is green, and because I have declared 0,0 for this face here. And of course, this is also left, because here is a sharp corner, so is the remaining for the radius of the ball and mill of 4 millimeter diameter. So, last thing is showing you a simulation. I can feed up. So with just one operation, I get a complete toolpath moving, smoothing with a spiral all around the part itself. So this is all. Let's go back to our presentation. And this is all for this global finish presentation. If you have any question, don't hesitate to ask us. Thank you.